I read the book iRobot when I was in ninth grade, and I thought, you know what, I want space robots to be where I go with my career. So that's when I knew what I was going to do. My family wasn't technical, but my dad had heard that Purdue was really good at engineering. So I made the choice very easy that this is the place to be. Mechanical engineers can do anything. That's why I chose it. They get to touch all of the different things. They know a little bit about electrical, they know a little bit about materials, they've got some of the stuff that civils do, I've always wanted to be more of a systems engineer, a control systems engineer in particular, and so I thought mechanical engineer is what gives me the tools to be able to do all of that. So I had Professor Chu for Megatronics. I remember spending all night in the computer lab trying to get that robot to climb a hill and drop a golf ball into a hole. I don't think we were ever successful at it, but we had a lot of fun trying. Co-ops, when you go here to Purdue, it's a really important program. Put my choices down, and NASA was one of the top ones. Got an interview and got in, which was thrilling for me. First started on the X-38 project right before it got canceled. It was supposed to be the lifeboat from the ISS. And then I went to robotics pretty soon thereafter and did simulation work. It was really valuable for me. I got job offers from both of them. I didn't actually look anywhere else because I knew that's where I wanted to go, and then chose the Johnson Space Center. And that kind of got me onto the Robonaut program. So it's a humanoid dexterous robot, and it's meant to be a spacecraft caretaker or a human astronaut assistant. It's meant to do the same sorts of tasks that humans can do. Things break all the time, and Robonaut is meant to be kind of the repairman. So I designed and executed all of the work we did with the Robonaut on orbit in the early stages. We then created legs, writing the new control system for that, which was a lot of fun. I enjoyed the applications a bit more, and then now I'm the project manager for it. And the technology we're developing right now on Robonaut will transfer and will apply to the next project. Our gateway, it's going to be in cislunar orbit, and people will only be there 30 days out of the year. This is the first time that we've had this really complex human spacecraft be uncrewed for any amount of time and expect it to still be functioning when people get there. And so to do that, we need abilities for that spacecraft to take care of itself, to be independent from us on the ground. We'll have hopefully robot systems in there. We're hoping to do science both inside and outside the gateway that help push us towards Mars. For example, understanding what radiation in that environment does to tissue, living tissue. So for example, a robot might have to go take care of the mice that are on board and doing the experiment by changing out, you know, food canisters or what have you. So everything we're doing is really trying to get our human presence onto another planet to really be able to understand that. There's a lot of secrets Mars hasn't unlocked for us yet, or even the moon, and to have a person on the surface and allow that person enough health to actually do some real useful work is what we're aiming for. My number one favorite thing about Purdue is how practical they are about real world problems. And so there's plenty of universities and plenty of places that kind of, they go do research to publish their papers or to get the theoretical results. And Purdue's focus is to go solve those real problems, and they have a great focus on practicality that I think will serve all of the graduates really well. Problems are all around us. Engineers are the ones that fix them.